The Truman Doctrine was the first part of the American aid to European countries intended to halt the advance of communism. It provided financial support to help the democratic governments in Greece and Turkey. President Truman proposed the plan to support free people who are resisting attempted subjugation by armed minorities or outside pressures. These countries had previously been supported by Britain, but it was nearing bankruptcy and asked the Americans to take over. The policy of financial aid won the support of the Republican Congress, but no American troops were sent to the region. A total of $400 million U.S. succeeded in ending the communist threat against Greece and Turkey. The Marshall Plan sent financial aid to the rest of Europe. It sent $3.3 billion to the United Kingdom, $2.3 billion to France, $1.4 billion to West Germany, $1.2 billion to Italy, $1.1 billion to the Netherlands, $7.8 million to Belgium and Luxembourg, $4.7 million to Austria, $3.9 million to Denmark, $3.8 million to Greece, $3.7 million to Norway, $3.5 million to Sweden, $2.5 million to Switzerland, $1.4 million to Turkey, $1.3 million to Ireland, $700,000 to Portugal, and $400,000 to Iceland. With this money, the U.S. effectively raised the economy of Europe to levels it had never seen. In his speech at Harvard University, George Marshall explained the need to support the modernization of Europe's crippled industry. The plan, which officially began in April of 1948, focused on removing trade barriers, rebuilding from the devastation of World War II, and making Europe prosperous again. It was offered to the communist states as well as the democratic ones, but the communists turned it down to avoid American influence. The North Atlantic Treaty Organization, or NATO for short, is a multi-government military alliance created on April 4, 1949 by the North Atlantic Treaty. It was created in the expectation of using collective security to fight communism. It saw its first use in the Korean War when it helped South Korea fight off the North under two U.S. Supreme Commanders. NATO's original members were Belgium, Canada, Denmark, France, Iceland, Italy, Luxembourg, Netherlands, Norway, Portugal, the United Kingdom, and the United States. In 1954, the Soviet Union tried to join NATO in order to preserve peace in Europe, but they were turned down for fears they were trying to weaken the treaty. During the Cold War, NATO conducted several large naval and aerial exercises to practice teamwork in the defense of certain countries. NATO still operates today with 28 members, most recently in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Libya.